It's not something to take lightly, but by answering a simple medical history questionnaire, it can give you answers that might be life-altering.
First degree relatives that have had colon cancer, oh geez, I've had two or more that I know of, unfortunately.
And how about second degree?
Again, I know that my grandmother passed away before she was 50, so what we can put 45 in there is probably, there was quite a few different cancers there.
Okay, let's calculate the probability. So,
greater than 50%.
And they say if it's greater than just 2.5%, they recommend that you be evaluated by a genetic counselor. Syndrome is a hereditary cancer condition, and what it does is it predisposes you and your blood relatives to a cancer diagnosis. And what it is exactly is that five different mismatch repair genes can be affected. And what these mismatch repair genes do is whenever you have cell division in your body and a new cell is created, there's DNA which is coded in the double helix strand. But sometimes it's coded improperly and incorrectly. So these mismatch repair genes come in and they fix it. But if you have Lynch syndrome, one of those genes doesn't always work. So it ends up not being corrected, and that can lead to cancer. I actually met a group of people who have Lynch syndrome when I was on a separate study that looked at colonoscopy procedures. And once they started talking to me about what Lynch syndrome was, I'm like, I have to look into this further. And I found out that the prevalence is 250 per 100,000. And when we look at something like ALS, which a lot of people have heard of, it's 3.9 per 100,000. And I had never heard of Lynch syndrome. And I said, okay, well, we need to study this further and see how families are being affected by it, where the issues are regarding communication, and why are people not receiving testing.
The next step once you found out that you had Lynch syndrome, because this is life-changing not only for yourself but for relationships, people, family?
Sure. The big thing I think that I took away from that was if I had this and it was hereditary, so although cancers are all genetic, they're all related to your genes, they aren't all hereditary, and in my case Lynch syndrome very much was hereditary, so this meant that there were other members of my family that very potentially could be carrying this, could be suffering from this, and they may or may not know. So for me, the first thing was to get in touch with my family wherever possible, encourage them to be tested. Now that I was tested and they'd identified the gene involved in mine, it would be very easy for them to get tested in their provinces. The same to be said for my brother. I have a blood brother who unfortunately did test positive as well, but it was because of my diagnosis that we were able to identify it in him before he had cancer. With Lynch syndrome, I think that's really the key, is we know that there's the possibility, but Lynch syndrome cancers have a very high rate of cure as long as they're caught early and basically don't get to that advanced stage. So that was key, was making sure that my family was checked, and then it was finding out what I needed to be cautious of. So I had very easily dismissed my initial symptoms because I was young and there was no reason that I should be feeling that way. I no longer can do that. I cannot take that risk anymore. Now, sometimes I feel like I'm being a hypochondriac, but I'm not. I just have to be very attentive to what my body is telling me and what I feel, and that I have to take my symptoms seriously, that if something's not right, I trust myself that it needs to be checked out.
All types of genetic testing, it's not black and white. You're not guaranteed a positive or a negative. There's also indeterminate, where they're not sure. And usually for that cohort of people, they recommend that you just go along with the organ surveillance that is recommended for Lynch syndrome, which would be annual colonoscopies and often upper endoscopy scopes and endometrial sampling for women, and also for women undergoing preventative surgeries where there's the removal of the uterus and the ovaries.
With Lynch syndrome, it is highly recommended that women, once they've had their children or are past childbearing years, do consider a full hysterectomy, complete BOL. That includes putting them into medically induced menopause. I've just turned 40. I'm not ashamed to say that. So this was a very big decision for me that although I had made the decision to not have children, both impacted by and not impacted by my Lynch syndrome diagnosis, but ultimately I will have to go through with another prophylactic surgery to remove my uterus and my fallopian tubes and ovaries just to prevent any chance of getting disease there. And hopefully that will be the end of my prophylactic surgeries at the very least. Was able to attend a conference initially in Rochester, that was in Minneapolis, but it was put on by the Rochester group, and then later to another very large information session put on by Lynch Syndrome International in Florida, where we actually got to speak with Dr. Lynch. I actually had my picture taken with the man who discovered my disease. Very grateful. It was great to meet people that absolutely knew inside and out what we were experiencing, and to gain that information. I always say I've never Googled so many words in my life, but I came away from there so much better educated, and now I just really want to continue sharing that information and making sure that other people have access to that education.
What would our medical system look like if we had this knowledge ahead?
I think first and foremost, if families talked about cancer diagnosis within the family, you know, called up a family member if you receive a cancer diagnosis, explain exactly what the diagnosis was, what organ, etc. That's a first step. And maybe a family history for a lot of conditions. In the future, they're thinking that will be important in identifying different genetic abnormalities. So it almost is a scientific breakthrough, but then also on the other hand, it's communication within the family that could make a large impact in the healthcare system.
There was a statistic that I read right on the international site that in the U.S. Alone, there's probably over 1 million people that have Lynch. Only 5% know that they have it, and all the rest.
So many families out there, no clue. And that's what I think when my dad died at 57. He had no idea that he had Lynch syndrome and that what he had might be passed on to his children. And I think I would never want him to do anything differently. I'm very grateful and very happy in my life. I love life. I love what I get to do and experience. I would never want him to feel guilty for having passed that on to me. But I think that if he could have been proactive in letting me know that that was a concern, he would have felt so much better, and he would have felt more at peace knowing that his children were looked after. We always say Lynch syndrome is not rare, it's just underdiagnosed.